Hey boys, it's HarmNone. Today I'm going to be talking about the new taxi business, in quotations, in Grand Theft Auto Online. And is it any good? The simple answer, no, it's not. However, I am going to be showing you guys what exactly goes on with the taxi business, how this thing works, what you have to do in order to start it, where you have to go, and all of that sort of stuff. So anyways, first of all, you're going to have to head over to the downtown cab company. It's right beside the casino. You guys may recognize it from story mode as Franklin. You can actually purchase the downtown cab company. Now, when you actually arrive to the downtown cab company, you will see that it says visit the downtown cab company to access new taxi work. Now, when you actually show up here, you're going to walk up to the doors and you will find out the taxi work is unavailable when you're part of an organization or an MC. So this is kind of interesting. This isn't something that I would have expected. I guess for things like Ghost Org and stuff like that, they don't want you to be able to use that while doing taxi work, I guess, is kind of the thought process behind that. Now, it will also let you know that the downtown cab company is now open for business. Begin taxi work from here to earn additional income. Successfully completing multiple fares without a break will increase the rewards. So you can do more and more fares, and as you do more fares, you will get a little bit more money. Now, how much money are we actually talking about? Well, as you guys can see, you have to drive all the way over to them and everything. And the first fare that I actually did was $117, and my tip was $1,040. So roughly $1,160 for completing this taxi work. Now, I only had to drive 1.1 miles, which isn't that far. However, for $1,100 in GTA, you can probably see how this is going. That's not exactly a lot of money. However, once you get to the second fare, as you guys can see, my pay went up by roughly $100. So basically each time that you do a fare in a row, your fare will go up by $100 until you reach the maximum tip amount, which is $1,930 on top of whatever the fare is. So you're going to be getting roughly $2,000 for completing these missions, as long as you don't crash the taxi. However, you can see after doing 11 taxi fares, my taxi was looking something like this, and not super hot. So just be aware that after you do 10 fares, you're probably going to have some damage on your taxi. You're probably going to mess up on, you know, each fare at least once, depending on how the AI are driving in GTA on the particular day that you're playing. Typically, I find they like to turn right in front of me, which we kind of know is a thing that Rockstar implemented into the game, which is very kind of them. After doing 11 fares with the taxi business, I made $17,000, and this took me about 25 minutes from start to finish, roughly, with, you know, driving to pick up the customers and everything, basically doing this as fast as I possibly could. Now, I also purchased the taxi for, I believe, $650,000 on Warstock Cash and Carry. I think you can unlock the trade price by completing a bunch of fares. So I believe that taxi work is actually accessible by anybody. I don't even think you need to buy the taxi. However, I ended up buying the taxi because I wanted it as a Pegasus vehicle, which it now is. If you purchase it on Warstock, you can request it through Pegasus, so that is kind of cool. I would definitely not recommend purchasing the taxi itself. I don't think that having the taxi for the vast majority of people is going to be very good, and certainly the taxi work does not pay a huge amount of money, so just, you know, be advised about that. I was really hoping that once I reached 10 fares, I would get, you know, a set amount of money that I was going to earn, and I was hoping that it would be sort of similar to how the agency safe operates. You know, if you complete 21 security contracts, you'll get $2,000 every in-game day. If you complete 101, you're going to get $10,000 every in-game day. I was hoping that the taxi work was going to be similar to that. I was hoping that I could, you know, eventually get to, like, you know, 200 fares completed and, you know, be making, like, I don't know, $20,000 per taxi trip. However, that's absolutely not the case, it looks like, as sad as that is. So the taxi business, I would say if you're a low level and you're trying to earn some money in GTA and you're trying to have a little bit of fun with it, you might want to check out the taxi business. You're also going to be able to get your driving skill leveled up really, really fast by doing this, and you're going to get a tiny amount of compensation for it as well. However, there are better ways to earn money in Grand Theft Auto Online, so I honestly can't really recommend this as a business to make money. You're not going to make much money with it. It's mostly about just just simply having fun. So that is pretty unfortunate that the taxi business is not very lucrative. I kind of expected it to be. I mean, it wouldn't exactly be realistic, you know, for Rockstar to pay us 20 grand per taxi, you know, delivery that we make. However, it also isn't realistic that Rockstar charges $3 million for every supercar. So you have that. Anyway, guys, the taxi business, not really worth running. If you're a very low level and you're trying to get your driving skill up and you want just a few pennies, the taxi business could be kind of fun for you. I'd say check it out if you're below level 20. And if you're above level 20, I mean, maybe do a couple fares just for fun, but definitely don't expect to make a lot of money with this business. It's just sadly not going to be very fun. And the other thing is too, when you finish your taxi work and when you decide that you are done with your taxi work, the downtown cab company seems to have other ideas. I will play the final clip as the video ends here of me playing this live, so you guys can get my reaction to this. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, a like is of course appreciated. If not, dislike. Subscribe to my channel if you guys are new and for more videos like this. And I will see you all in the next video. Until then, take care. Peace. After 10 fares, oh gee. Okay, so it maxes to 10. It's not any higher than 10. Oh, the maximum tip bonus is $1,930. So we're gonna get like 2 grand for each one of these missions that we complete, and 1.5 miles we have to drive for this dude. Oh god. Okay. So to make your money back from your taxi, you're literally gonna have to do an ungodly amount of fares. Like an insane amount of fares. That is pretty annoying. My tip got reduced. That's all right. Serious bro moment. Just dropped my controller like an idiot. Okay. So yeah, so the taxi business is yeah, it's good for low levels, and I'd say that's about it. And there's really not much point in purchasing a taxi, it doesn't seem like, guys. So hopefully you made it this far into the episode so you can hear that before you buy a taxi, because yeah, that's not very great. I've earned a total of 16 grand and it's been a while. So we're gonna no, I don't want to pick up the customer. Let me out of the taxi. No, let me, no, downtown cab company, no, you're gonna let me out of the taxi. It won't let me out of the taxi, guys. Okay, well, I know what my only option is then. It's to die in the taxi. I guess. Can I literally, do I? You completed 11 fares to earn $16,918. Now am I gonna have to, if I go back into the taxi, am I gonna have to do another 10 fares to get the maximum tip bonus again? Like, what's the deal? Like, what? Okay, I don't know, man.